Shabbat shalom. My name is Gage Diffie, and I am blessed to be able to share the first five with you today. I really love what Chris, Ephraim, and Daniel are doing here, getting other people involved, and I know that Chase will be doing a first five here soon, too, so I'm just really excited that their vision of this congregation is very communal, and that's really what their heart is, and I love that. But this Torah portion is Genesis 32, and it starts in verse 3, and then it goes through 36, verse 43. So it's a pretty long Torah portion. So I'm really just going to focus on this first kind of two chapters of it, which is basically the more popular part of the Torah portion. And it's called Vayishlach, which means, "and he sent." Comes from the Hebrew word shalach, which just means to send. And so this Torah portion starts, and a few chapters earlier, you've got Jacob, who steals his brother's birthright and blessing, and he goes away and lives with Laban, and then he's coming back, and he kind of prepares to meet Esau, and this guy's like trembling. He's just terrified. He doesn't see any other way but just like, He's expecting a violent interaction is what he's expecting, a violent encounter. And you see this because he divides his camp up into two. So if Esau attacks one, well, then at least he's got another one left. But I also love this Torah portion because the author writing this story is just beautifully weaving these Hebrew idioms and word puns together. And so in Genesis 32:22, whenever Jacob wakes up and he encounters the man or God that he's going to wrestle, his name, obviously Jacob's name in Hebrew is Yaakov, and Yaakov crosses the Yabok brook, and he Yaakevs this man. So Yaakev means to wrestle. It comes from Akev, which means dust, so it's like you're rolling around in the dust. It's literally where they got that word. And so I love just little snippets like this of these Hebrew word puns, because you just miss it when you read it in English, but if you're reading it in Hebrew, it's like Yaakov went to Yabok and Yaakev. It's like this beautiful poetry that the author is working with here. And so he gets here and he wrestles this man. And then after this man blesses him and they wrestle for a while, he says, "I've met God face to face." So commentator, it's kind of this mystical, kind of cryptic scene almost, because the story calls it a man, and then Jacob says, "I've seen God face to face." So commentators have spent countless hours trying to figure out, like, okay, was this like a river demon? Was it actually God? Was it just a man? Was it an angel of God, a messenger of God? But I don't think necessarily that's the point of the story. The author tells us that his name is changed to Israel because he's striven with God and striven with man. And so after he gets blessed by this man, or as he calls God, he's prepared to meet Esau. And remember, from the wrestling match, he's got the Bible says that his hip came out of socket. Well, if your hip came out of socket, most likely you wouldn't be able to walk. So this is kind of, there's actually some funny ways to interpret this, but some people believe it's the sciatic nerve that was struck. And so he could limp and walk, but he was very injured basically. And so he's going to meet Esau, and he's limping, and he sees Esau, and you know he's terrified. And it just says Esau ran to meet him, and he fell on his neck and kissed him. And falling, like, I imagine this scene where, like, someone's, like, passing out almost, like, and they just, someone catches him. Like, he's just so overwhelmed that he just falls on his neck. And it's just this beautiful scene because I believe it speaks to this theme in Genesis of sibling rivalry, where reconciliation is at the climax of sibling rivalry, rather than just violence solving this issue. You see this in the story of Jacob Esau, and you see it later in the story of Joseph and his brothers. And so when I read this Torah portion, that's just really what hit home with me was this, you know, blessed are the merciful, for they shall be given mercy. And blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called children of God. And so many times I think, and in my own life at least, that it's very easy to just hold grudges against someone who's wronged me, or to just like not want to be a peacemaker and show mercy in a certain situation, where rather I'm like expecting some kind of violent interaction. And I think that's just what really hit home with me, because Jacob just stole his brother's birthright and his blessing. And we get called a name and get offended and don't want to reconcile something with our brother. And so that's just really what was on my heart this morning. So Ephraim, if you would come up and you can start, you can bless the kids and take this mic from me. But first I'd like to pray. Father, Abba Father, we just, it's stories like this that just remind us how we need to be kingdom-minded people. And we need to take the words of Yeshua to heart, and that we need to be peacemakers, and we need to be merciful and show mercy to people. Lord, may you just fill us with your spirit, and may we just live at peace with everyone as far as it depends on us. Lord, move in us, and may we usher in your kingdom on earth as it is in heaven. In Yeshua's name we pray. Amen. Yeah.
Slaves, but no plantation. 27 million.